Szanowni Państwo, jest mi niezmiernie
miło. Ladies and gentlemen, I have this great pleasure to welcome you at the sixth edition of the European Agricultural Forum, organized by the European Fund for Development of the Polish Rural Areas. Good afternoon. We go back in history a long time. Initially, we were meeting within the group of friends of Mr. Śliż to commemorate the anniversary of his death, and then later on we followed this formula of debates about the future of the Polish urban areas. And now we're debating the future of the Polish agriculture sector, both in Poland and Europe. And we had six interesting panels today, and now we gathered here to listen to the debate. I would like to welcome all of you, ladies and gentlemen, cordially. Well, good afternoon to all of you. A big round of applause. First, I would like to welcome the Minister of Agriculture and Development of Polish Rural Areas, Mr. Czesław Siekierski, the Deputy Vice Minister Adam Nowak. I would like to welcome on a foreign guest, Milan Dadurek, Deputy Minister of the Czech Republic. Welcome.
Witam bardzo serdecznie.
And also, I would like to welcome the host of this center, the governor of the Podkarpackie region,
and Piotr Pilch,
deputy head of the regional assembly of this region, and Mr. Kruczek, who is the member of the governing board of this region. And then we have the head of the regional assembly of Kujawy and Pomeranian region. Then we have with us the chief inspector for plant and seed protection, then Mr. Legawiec, the president for restructuring modernization of the agricultural sector, Aleksandra Hadzik, who is the president of the Farming and Agricultural Social Insurance Institution Director. Then we have the director of the local farming support organization. And then we have members of the farming support centers. Welcome. I would like to welcome all representatives of the Polish Parliament, Polish MPs, representatives of embassies and representatives of local self-governments. Then we have members of the academia, members of NGOs, and all farmers. Welcome. Please excuse me if I don't list you all and introduce you formally. I would like to welcome the management board and the program council of this foundation with Artur Balasz and Mr. Łuszczewski, Mr. Kandyns. I would also like to welcome our partners of the forum, our strategic partner, Biogen Biotechnological Company, and the main partners, Polmlek Group, the national food producing group, and other partners of the forum, including our regional partners. I would like to welcome all our media patrons and all exhibitors of this forum. Thank you very much for being with us. I would like to extend my particular words of welcome to the members of the family of late Józef Śliż. We have been meeting here for so many years to commemorate him and celebrate the anniversary of his death. And now I would like to ask the host, Piotr Pilch, deputy head of the regional assembly of the Subcarpathian region, to take the floor. Sir, the floor is yours. Let's welcome
Tak, gościnna ziemia, Mr. Pilch. Panie ministrze, panowie ministrowie, panie minister,
ministries, ladies and gentlemen, governor, it is my honor and pleasure to welcome you on behalf of the marshal of this region, Mr. Ortyl, and on behalf of the entire self-government of this region. It is our pleasure to debate these very important topics here at this G2A Arena Center, Congress and Conference Center. It is our great venue that has been serving us so well. Ladies and gentlemen, we have so many important and heated debates happening now and happening in the past, starting in 1981 here in Rzeszów and in a location called Ustrzyki, agreements of local farmers and employers were signed, and here farmers in the place called Medyka on the border are awaiting the results of discussions here. They have high hopes about the results of these debates. We are very much looking forward to the outcomes of these discussions, and I hope that the roundtable will contribute to that. Enjoy the Congress and have a fruitful discussion. Thank you.
Częściowo pan zapowiedział już krótki filmik.
So partially, sir, you introduce a very short film about Józef Śliż, the person who is the example of beliefs and persistence in following one's values.
Jego ręce pielęgnowały plony ziemi.
He was an active farmer. He served the country and the freedom of citizens with his deeds. So we could build this movement around him. He was an undisputable leader of farmers' solidarity. We could compare him to an important a politician and prime minister of the between the war period. He was an activist operating and fighting for farmers and in the name of farmers. He also negotiated with the governmental party. In 1981, peasants went on strike and presented a list of postulates, of demands. The key one was to guarantee the ownership of land to peasants. So Józef Śliż played a very important role representing peasants' interest and preparing for the roundtable negotiations. He was engaged in all important negotiations. Peasants' farmers' solidarity can speak in its own voice at last. And this voice is full, could be filled with bitterness, but we are sitting here at the round table, and for me, this is the symbol of a new start, of a new opening, of us regaining our freedom to speak.
Wolność, solidarność i dialog.
So freedom, solidarity and dialogue. This mission is continued by the European Fund for Farmers, Artur Balázs, who is a farmer and the head of the foundation's chapter, will take the floor right now. Sir, the floor is yours, and we would like to invite you to give us the opening, well, the introduction to this debate. Thank you, sir.
To był kawałek historii.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, so that was, we had this glimpse
tutaj w Rzeszowie, ona się
rozpoczynała. On the history. We experienced that here in Rzeszów. It all started in 1981 back then. It was easier back then. We had just one enemy, one opponent, and the problems that we had to solve, there were Polish problems. And I'm very happy to see so many farmers with us.
Problemy,
because we're here prompted by so many issues which are common to farmers. They haven't been solved yet, and they pose a threat to the future of our farms. This debate is not going to be easy, but it's determined by the intention to look for good solutions, solutions that would serve the future of the Polish farmers and the future of the EU. Some earlier decisions of the European Commission of opening the European market without any critical thinking and allowing Ukraine into that market destabilized the market. Ukraine is an unquestionable leader when it comes to food production. Well, it will be very difficult to change that. This venue is the right venue for this debate. So as I was saying, way back 30, 40 years ago, we succeeded in reaching an agreement. And I hope that that glimpse on the history of negotiations will contribute to the success of our debate today. Well, the farmers' protests are fully justifiable, and we need to look for a solution that is good both for the EU and for the Polish farmers. A solution cannot be reached overnight. This is a long, difficult, and responsible process that requires the vision, the determination, and courage, both on the part of our current government. Well, this government is not to blame for what we have right now, but the farmers themselves, they must be partners. They must work towards solving the situation, and it's worth listening to them today. So we have the outbreak of protests prompted by this new Green Deal and prompted by the situation in Poland caused by some food security concerns. And it will be difficult to find a solution here. But we do not have any choice. Well, Ukraine is about to enter the EU, and that should bring about this reflection that this Ukraine joining the EU cannot lead to the situation when the European market and the Polish market is demolished, even if we consider the situation in Ukraine and the war. We have this long, direct border with Ukraine. So therefore, it is the easiest solution to place these food products from Ukraine on the Polish market. Those who do not have clear conscience, they come to the defense of the Ukrainian food producers. They join their protests and they suggest that it is not easy to find an agreement. We need to reach an agreement. We must reach an an agreement. Ladies and gentlemen, it is not a worthy thing to disrupt this debate. Farmers should benefit from the negotiations. As I said, these negotiations, these talks will not be easy. These talks will not be very friendly, but I believe that all these disputes can be settled. Ladies and gentlemen, I remember farmers' protests in the past where all pollen was blocked or our roads were blocked, and we sat at the table and negotiated and we reached an agreement peacefully. So now, today, we also need to sit together and debate and negotiate ways and means to solve this crisis. So this is what we expect from the Polish authorities. This is what we expect from the Minister of Agriculture. We expect them to find solutions to these difficult issues and problems suffered by farmers. So we want to sit at the table and negotiate with this feeling that we would like to reach an agreement that solves the most difficult problems. And we truly hope that we can do it. Thank you so much.
Zapraszam uczestników tej debaty, pana Wiesława Gryna, Zamojskie Towarzystwo Rolnicze Oszukana Wieś. W kolejności alfabetycznej panu zapraszam, zajmować miejsca. Pana Artura Kącika, Artur rolnik Kącik, protestujący na granicy świecką. Former, protesting at the border crossing in Świecko. Roman Kondrów, Podkarpacka Oszukana Wieś.
From the Podkarpacie region.
Pan Tomasz Obszański.
Tomasz Obszański.
NSZZ Solidarność Rolników Indywidualnych.
NSZZ Solidarność Rolników Indywidualnych. A
pan
Farmers
Filip
Trade
Pawlik,
Union.
Agrounia.
Filip Pawlik, Agrounia.
I pan Władysław Serafin, Krajowy
Władysław
Związek
Serafin.
Rolników i Kółek i Organizacji Rolniczych. Bardzo proszę.
An Association
oraz
of
pan
Farmers
Andrzej
Associations.
Rolnik, Andrzej Sobociński. Na
a farmer protesting in the region of Żuławy.
I zapraszam oczywiście pana Czesława Siekierskiego, ministra rolnictwa i rozwoju wsi. Serdecznie witamy i zapraszamy.
Sir,
oraz panią Joannę Czaple, dyrektor Departamentu Czapla, Płatności Bezpośrednich w Ministerstwie Rolnictwa i Rozwoju Wsi, i pana Waldemara Gubę, dyrektora Departamentu Mr. Guba. Rynków Rolnych. Czy państwo są
from
z nami?
The Agricultural Markets Department. Are you with us?
Dyrektor. Ja tylko technicznie do
welcome,
powiem,
Madam
że
Director.
Czas,
a housekeeping remark.
Będzie przez moderatora.
Let's talk about time. The moderator will be keeping time.
Ekranach, tak
you will be seeing it on the screen so that it is easier for you to follow how much time has elapsed and how much time is left. So here we are, representatives of the farmers' associations that are participating in the protests. We have Mr. Balasz, is the host and the moderator of this meeting. Good luck.
Proszę państwa, jak państwo widzą, niełatwo było przy tym stole.
As you see, it was no easy task to gather farmers here who represent various circles, milieus, groups that are on strike, and also to include the representatives of existing trade unions. By no means is it a perfect situation. Yes, there are certain doubts and reservations you might have about any of the participants, including myself. This, however, is a very difficult situation. It's going to be a hard conversation, and here we need to look for optimal solutions. We have the will and determination to look for answers. I will begin with Mr. Green. I'll be given the floor to the participants one by one. They will have 3 to 5 minutes each.
ministra, który będzie skrzętnie to notował.
The minister's team is working the background. They'll be taking minutes and they will be trying to take all this input to include it in a draft of an agreement. Ministers, ladies and gentlemen, any protest, any rebellion stems out of one thing. It's about people who have not been listened to. It all boils down to that. And we need to be listened to. History sees twists and turns, and this one, this is rather one of them. This is one of those turns. One of many, I believe, that there will be more of them, and they will be even worse.
Ale po każdej burzy musi przyjść.
Well, it's a stormy time. There needs to be sunshine after any storm. We need time to come to an agreement. Now I'm addressing Mr. Minister. For that agreement to happen, there needs to be goodwill and give and take. That's what is necessary on both sides. We have our threshold requirements, our expectations. That is what we have agreed on, and the governmental side it also needs to give something. Now, I would like to tackle the following. What we need are tools. We need long-term solutions. It is something that we have been postulating for years. I believe that the first letter was sent in 2009, in September 2009. Ever since, we've been asking for the following. We want ports, harbors. We want them to be expanded. We want competition there.
10
million tons need to be exported. Everybody is proud of how much they're exporting. I mean grain. And yes, it's okay. It's right to help Ukraine, but to help Ukraine we need tools. And we need to develop our rail, central lay connection. It is absolutely central. Without that, this grain transportation system can never be controlled properly. Ports. We wouldn't be where we are, but for certain things that happened a long time ago. Now, we could have followed a different path, the Romanian path 2 years ago. Now it's too late. Mr. Minister, you could say it's too late. We have more important things, but you need to take the first step. You need to start somewhere. And one more thing, the Green Deal. We saw this trailer promoting the Podkarpacie region. Look at how beautifully Poland is located. Let us not for the Green Deal. Let us simply keep what we already have, because it is our legacy. Just let us do what we need to do, focus on what we already have. That should be sufficient. Thank you.
Roman Kondruch, Podkarpacka oszukana wieś.
The countryside that's been cheated. Hello, welcome, and thank you to all the farmers, those that were protesting, that were in the streets. They channeled all this pain, the pain that we are feeling in the agricultural sector. And a warm welcome to the ministry. I respect the farmers. So remember, I need to say that we have to respect the farmers, those that are protesting at various border crossings, Medyka, Korczowa and others. It's a pity that nobody has made sure that the border is actually properly controlled. That is the so-called technical grain. It should no longer be coming in. I have spoken to the veterinary authorities. So I asked him, is the technical grain coming into Europe? Yes, Romek, he said, yes, it continues to come in. But we have been fighting to avoid that. We didn't want the corn to come in and the oil. We were supposed to be a transit country, but it keeps coming back from the German border. It keeps coming back to Poland. We have no tools to properly verify it, but we have friends and colleagues, and they have reported that those products, they stay here. So the border needs to be controlled. And yes, we need Polish-Ukrainian exchange, I understand that. And people suffer, shipping companies suffer. The question is, what kind of pressure can we exert on the government to be listened to and taken seriously? We hoped that the Prime Minister would host us and talk to us. I don't want to get too political. And yet, I believe that the Prime Minister has been neglecting us. He should meet with us, sit together. So I hope that we can have a consensus here with the minister. I hope that we can reach an agreement, but both parties need to be willing. The farmer said, Roman, you go there, but if you sign something that we do not agree with, don't count on our compliments. The thing is, the situation is very bad. The prices have been nosediving. We need to remember not only about those large farms, 10,000 hectares, but also about the small ones, 10 hectares or so. We are the fuel. We are the fuel that powers this society. Remember, if you have a vehicle, a car, it needs proper fuel to function properly. If the fuel is poor, the things are not going to end up well. Artur Kącik, a farmer. He represents the protest taking place at Świecko border crossing. Hello to everybody. Welcome. We have a delegation from the western part of Poland too. We've all been protesting all over Poland. The same issue. Farmers in tears, waiting, looking forward to the result of our talks. I represent the Lubuskie region, and we've had a major issue there, namely drought. And it's been hitting us for years, not only our region, but others too. So, come May and June, we are short of water. The climate has been changing. Somebody has come up with this app. I have no idea who's the author, but it should be changed. Or rather, we need to get rid of it entirely. We need to go back to the previous solution. We used to have committees set up by mayors, and they would go to farmers and ask, have you had any losses? Okay, let's report it. And that's something that is quite painful to us. We've had this problem for years now, year on year. poultry breeding, another problem. I represent the Lubusz Voivodeship, and we are a powerhouse when it comes to poultry production. The situation is dramatic. Now, there is a Turkey Producers Association, and the situation, as they say, is awful. The costs have been skyrocketing. As a result, the poultry producers don't have any margins left. And we've heard that we can no longer use gas to heat chickens. It's unacceptable. We have aligned ourselves with European standards. What do we do now? We live and operate close to the western border. My colleagues, they are in Świeck, protesting there. They call me and they say, Artur, talk to the minister, ask him for his help. And here we are, and I represent the Lubusz Voivodeship. Here we are to solve our issues. We need to sit together. And please remember, we have backs against the wall. That's where we are at this point. Thank you so very much.
Pan Tomasz Obszański, przewodniczący Solidarności Rolników
Solidarność Rolników Indywidualnych.
Jakby dopowiadając tutaj
an association of retail farmers to follow up on the issue of drought. There is this app. And basically, the losses are estimated somewhere at a desk. What's the impact? Basically, there are situations where there is no hope to receive any compensation. It's not fair, it's not right, it's not just. Mr. Minister, or rather, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Minister, farmers, we've already heard today Józef Ślisz died years ago, and a quote, freedom, solidarity and dialogue. This was his creed, his motto. And we should remember about this creed at all times. We are in a very difficult situation. We are with our backs against the wall. And the agriculture sector may simply trip and fall at any moment. The problems have been growing for years now. Now, I'm not addressing the minister specifically. The thing is, though, that the people employed at the ministry should sit down and get to work, because many regulations are drafted there. And there are many problems that can be solved swiftly, and many problems should be solved in the ministry. The Green Deal, it's been mentioned, and I believe that it should be split into member states. Each member state should follow certain different national rules. Our farms are different from German farms, which are in turn different from Italian farms. And we need to concentrate on the Polish issues. We should come up with certain Green Deal solutions, or maybe simply fail to implement it. We use hardly any fertilizers and plant protection compounds compared to, say, Germany. So we should be the role model here. We, the solidarity of farmers, have been talking about it for a long time. We talked about it to a number of ministers, including Minister Komalczyk, to Minister Telus. They've been visiting farmers, and yet no conclusions have been drawn. So we need to take stock. We need to examine our conscience. Certain things here in Poland need to change.
potrzeby, co odnośnie wszystkich.
We have serious needs across the board in various markets. We need to analyze all that. Many issues can be solved here at a national level. There are things that you can solve in Brussels, but there are many things that can be solved here in Poland. What we need is goodwill. So various markets, including dairy and others, there are issues there, and support is needed.
So that support should come from that war shield, the shield that should shield our farms. It is just a matter of goodwill. These funds should be designated to support our farms so we can survive all the mishaps which are happening right now. So with that, sir, we would like to encourage you to work as much as draft bills and draft legislation which should be in the pipeline. Well, so far we can only see people from the ministry and activists who show off in the mass media. We can do a lot ourselves if we only work hard. Thank you. Right. Now, Filip Pawlik, the representative of Agro Unia Farmers Organization. Good afternoon.
Podstawności tych strajków nie trzeba wiele mówić. Strajki są.
I don't think we need to talk much about the strikes. There is a very good reason for us to go on strike. But the strikes are caused by poverty of Polish farmers. Polish farmers, we haven't been prepared for the import of produce, food produce from Ukraine. It's not only about cereals, it's also about importing eggs, vegetable and soft fruit. I expect the government to take action instantly. There should be actions, and the government should meet our demands instantly. We need to have solutions, and solutions that go beyond the system solutions, which can be applied here and now. Here at this table, I cannot imagine us leaving this venue without signing an agreement. It must happen here and now, because this is why we're here, and this is my expectation towards ministers, towards all who have a say in that. Władysław Serafin, the chairman of the Polish Association of Farmers groups and organizations. Well, good afternoon.
Upływ czasu, jaki mamy z protestami rolniczymi, jest tak uzasadnione, że
we've been witnessing farmers protests. And they haven't started yesterday. I want to warn you that if we do not reach an agreement at one of the stages of the process right now, we may lose the chance to reach an agreement. Well, actually, a conversation, a top discussion with the Prime Minister simply manifested several deficiencies of the state. How come that the great, this New Deal, Green New Deal, was adopted by the majority of the EU states? Last night, I was listening to a member of the Polish Academy of Science speaking about the Polish farms and farmers, and I had to turn off my TV. She was talking about fragmentation of Polish farms. She was talking about small size of Polish farms. So educated people who present such image of the Polish village, who describe Polish villages as places full of tractors, well, I don't think we can reach an agreement like that. These are technological issues, technological progress. We farmers, we must progress with time. When we buy any machinery to work our land, to work our farms, we go deeply into debt. Now, let me go back to my debate, our debate with Mr. Tusk, the Prime Minister. And if we sit there for hours and there is a debate and there is a dispute about the crops, the cereals that have entered Poland, some say 5 tons. 5 million tons, some say 2 million tons. And actually, no one really knows knows the hard facts. So the fact is that we do not have the mechanisms in place. We want Brussels to pay us back for all the losses imposed on us by this chaos and by this Green Deal. So we want Brussels to pay us to subsidize our production. And I want to emphasize that this is not our fault. It is, we didn't do any wrong by continuing food production. This country has been poorly managed for many years. We could see the weakness of the state in 2023. Well, the borders were spectacularly closed for 3 months and they had to be reopened. It's not about closing borders. Well, absolutely, it is our demand to demand restoration of the legal status that was in place before the Ukrainian war. If the Ukrainian authorities say that this is only 5% of their food production that goes through Poland, well, I disagree because we could see all these crops entering Poland nevertheless on several occasions. And I demand customs and demand measures imposed. We do not need any resolutions from the European Parliament. This is the decision of the EU government, Ursula von der Leyen. Well, she lifted these restrictions. So these restrictions can be reimposed. So restrictions, customs, etc., they can be reintroduced. What we organized in Świecko on the German border, where we had to run our protests there, because of heavy fines that we were risking. So let me close by quoting what we said when protesting on the German border. We are protesting on the German border, and we will continue protesting on the German border as long as you keep the Ukrainian border open. Well, we don't demanded Ukrainian border to be closed in physical terms. We demand reintroduction of these regulations, of these restrictions that applied back then. Thank you. Andrzej Sobociński, a farmer representative of protesters in Nowy Dwór Żuławy, which is the area of Poland with the highest class soil. Well, again, that area saw the largest, the most dramatic protest in 1989 and later on. Well, I hope that we won't have that today. But truly, these were huge challenges. Sir, thank you so much for inviting me. And on behalf of my boys from my area, I thank you for inviting us here. Well, I was there with the protesters back in, well, that was 1999. And my voice cracks when I talk about it. We had that second meeting with the Prime Minister Donald Tusk. He said that he had read the entire Green New Deal, and he said that he didn't understand it. But I was thinking, how did you vote it? How could you vote it? Everyone voted for it. And now the question, the thing is that first Poland ended up having that legislative solution that, and again, we have this delay by the 15th of February, so we can start farm our land in April. And then the nightmare of this Green Deal is conditionality. So the sixth and seventh and the eighth condition, they are being a bit laxed recently, but then we have this conditionality, but then we have this entire Green Deal. And my proposal was, as we presented it to the Prime Minister, it was a very simple and straightforward. We wrote as farmers do. So we had 16 eco-schemes in Poland. And Germans, they just had three. I think it's an excessive effort. It's being overzealous here. Actually, I must say that although I've been trying to analyze it, I get lost. There are 20 national regulations. And Prime Minister Tusk said that we could change that, or we could cancel these regulations, but we cannot because they are closely linked to that European legislation about the.
My żeśmy zaproponowali
in Germany, there is 178 euro and per kilometer. In here we suggested six. And we need this political will. Perhaps not 178, perhaps 140, because we have certain allocations. But we want these concepts to be clear, clearly structured, and straightforward. But, sir, I am a deep and a big proponent of food security. It pains me to see the unprocessed goods, which are now transiting the Ukrainian border. Now, I've learned today that certain
I teraz tak.
goods,
substancje obniżane, żebyśmy mieli zdrową żywność.
Are,
no już doszliśmy do tego, że już nam to nie szkodzi.
Just were certain components or certain fertilizers which are banned in Poland and in the EU are not banned in Ukraine and were fed with what is destructive and what is harmful. I had a daughter, but she's no longer with us, and I heard from professor of medicine that 50% of her morbid illness was caused by food. So on the one hand, we should see that the Green Deal imposes certain restrictions, but on the other hand, we are poisoned. We are poisoned and we are prevented from producing organic food.
Panie ministrze,
minister.
Myślę, że spotyka się pan z taką dość reprezentatywną.
The way I see it is you are meeting with a group of farmers that is quite representative of Poland. And this is a very important moment.
Również jako rolnik w swoim
imieniu. I'm also a farmer. I'm speaking for myself, but also on behalf of other farmers. The Minister of Agriculture could be the best representative of farmers, could be their champion. The Minister has the best position, but first they need to be strong and determined when they take decisions. Mr. Minister, we count on you. Mr. Minister.
Tak, szanowni rolnicy, drodzy przedstawiciele,
dear farmers, dear representatives, chair, ladies and gentlemen, firstly, thank you for this meeting.
Na seminariach w Jesionce podejmowało się ważne sprawy dla rolnictwa.
After all, at seminars, important decisions would be taken for Poland, for the agricultural sector, for the food chain. So Jesionka is an important event in our calendars. It's a part of assessment. We've heard that this debate is difficult, but it is necessary. And farmers need to participate in this debate. This is a special moment, a special situation. I remember I had this talk with Minister Banaś. I said that this situation is different from other protests because the external circumstances are different. So that's what I said to Minister Balázs. So these are special circumstances. Look at the protests, at their scale. Look at the structure.
One były w dużej mierze samoczynne w wielu miejscach.
In many locations, these were grassroots protests. And we see a new quality when it comes to contacts, communication, networking, you've got social media. These factors change things. I've held my post for 3 months now. Since the very beginning, I've been saying that farmers have been protesting and their cause is just. I've been supporting farmers, and some people said that, you know, who do you support? I would respond, I'm the Minister of Agriculture, but to be the Minister of Farmers is something that you need to deserve. I am a farmer's son, a peasant's son. I've been dealing with agriculture throughout my life, also when I was an MEP, member of the European Parliament. So I have the sense of responsibility. That's what guides me. I visited all the border crossings, all of them, various times, including at night. Some people say you travel too much, because when you travel so much, you legitimize those protests. That's how some people saw it. That has been my introduction. I understand that this is a special situation. Agriculture is an important and special part of the national economy. It is dependent on the climate, on the weather, but also on external circumstances. And here, the external circumstances have played a very important role. We saw the Russian invasion on Ukraine. This war has changed the situation dramatically also in the global markets.
Nie podzielałem, mówiłem o błędności, o błędzie Unii Europejskiej, że w takiej formule.
I would say that the EU has made a mistake when it opened the market in a certain way. Effectively, what we see is that the Ukraine is in the EU because it has full access to its market. I know that it's a form of helping Ukraine. The thing is, the EU took an easy way out because the countries that are paying the price are those countries that have a border with Ukraine. It's the farmers that pay the highest price.
Ale jednocześnie są pewne procesy światowe.
And please, still remember that there are certain global processes that are ongoing. Russia is a gas producer. It couldn't sell the gas, so they started, or rather Russia, started taking the gas to produce fertilizers. And they turned it into fertilizers. They used those fertilizers to produce grain. And as a result, the other producers, that is Poles and Ukrainians, suffered. And as a result, the prices in the global markets have been dropping. They continue to decrease. The prices are low. You cannot sell the produce. We know that what the situation is like. We know it's spring and the silos are full. On top of that, you have production costs, you've got inflation, you've got profitability. All these factors have impacted the farming situation, and this situation is very difficult indeed. 20 million pigs, this is how many we had. Now we have half of that, roughly. As a result, you have a surplus of grain that is not being used here, locally. We import piglets, we import meat from Germany, but some of it we process and then export. The situation is difficult, I know, but we have a surplus when it comes to our foreign trade. So we have a 19 million euros worth of surplus in this trade. When it comes to fork to farm, farmers are the weakest link because they have little impact on the chain, on the prices. There is no vertical integration between the farmers, the processing industry, and so on and so forth. So the farmers' financial situation is heavily impacted here. Let me move on. We have done certain things, and not all of them are seen. We have acted. And we have worked with Ukraine, and we have acted in the context of the Green Deal. We have been meeting the Ukrainian party quite often. And let me say the following. Ukraine has been a very good lobbyist in Brussels. They've been quite effective in their lobbying efforts. They want to keep this European market to be open to them.
najlepszą formą byłoby jak najszybsze przystąpienie do negocjacji.
So basically, it would be best if they started EU accession negotiations ASAP.
Bez regulacji unijnych, bez włączenia tego w sposób...
EU regulations are necessary. The EU needs to act responsibly. Without that, the problem cannot be solved within the framework of bilateral Polish-Ukrainian relations. I believe that Prime Minister Tusk talked about it too. I mentioned Buzek, but it's my mistake. So Minister Tusk said the following: we need to agree on regulations. The thing is, humanitarian help and economic help is different, the military help is different, and trade issues are a different thing. And we've held talks, systematic talks. We met a week ago, I went to Ukraine, I went to Brussels, and there have been some concessions, but it's very difficult to accomplish those. We need to be forceful to gain them. And there will be a joint meeting of the Polish and Ukrainian government. It's going to happen in Warsaw. We want a number of issues to be solved there. ATM, you know that. The trade with Ukraine was liberalized for a year, then it got extended 23 to 24. Now there is another extension, 24 to June 25. And we have talked to Dobrovskis. We've been in Brussels, we had talks there. So the Green Deal and ATM, the talks there are quite difficult. Let me say that the farmers were protesting in Poland, in Germany, in France, in Brussels, and we heard that it's a mistake and the farmers are paying the price. The Commission needs to take that into account. They need to listen to all these farmers that have been protesting in a number of countries. And that forced the Commission's hand. Basically, they had to yield to some extent. Coming back to the protests. Those protests were very responsible in their nature. Yes, there were moments when things got a little bit more chaotic, but as long as it was just the farmers that were protesting, those protests were really responsibly held.
Najpierw może zacznę od spraw Ukrainy. Chcemy i te poprawki do ATM-u, które uwzględniają...
So, ATM, there are some amendments there. We are talking about various contingents for eggs, for sugar, for poultry. Mind you, things were being postponed. The Commission didn't want to talk about that. At the same time, they were afraid not to work on that. So they did table these proposals, but quite late. Now, the Parliament suggested that we have quotas or contingents, and once you've crossed those thresholds, taxes would kick in. But the thing is, we've got talks, the Parliament, the Council, and other players. They want the ATM to be extended, and some products would be covered by certain regulations so that once a threshold has been crossed,
prowadzimy rozmowy dwustronne, aby były także licencjonowanie, które by porządkowało sprawy, żeby było pod pewną kontrolą były.
And so basically, after a certain threshold has been crossed, tariffs would kick in. I know that I'm running out of time.
Panie ministrze, tutaj słuchający zwracają uwagę, że prosili.
The listeners are saying that they would like to hear more details. They would like you to speak more to the point and in greater detail. The proposals are there. They are being discussed. And yes, we are holding talks with Ukrainians. These are difficult talks. We are quite clear. Prime Minister Tusk said that we need to come to an agreement, and if not, we will change tack. Let us remember that we are also an exporter. Produce goes both ways. We export dairy, vegetables, frozen products too. So we need to keep that in mind. So let's talk about our trade balance. We have a 6 billion euros worth of surplus. There's also a negative result there too.
Zielonego Ładu, to rozmowy między przewodniczącym premierem Tuskiem a przewodniczącą von der Leyen.
So, Madam von der Leyen sat down with Mr. Tusk and they included certain demands.
Obowiązkowego ugorowania,
so, obligatory fallow systems would be replaced with voluntary systems. Now, crop rotation solutions would also be changed. Also, when it comes to soil solutions, there would be national solutions to some extent. Also, when it comes to smaller farms, it would be possible not to fine the farmers if they do not follow the conditionality.
Thank you. Right. Well, at this point in time, I would like to allow questions from the floor. I believe that these would be questions that would go, that would be addressed at the minister. But ladies and gentlemen, please limit yourselves to very short questions or to very short comments. Do not offer us long speeches. Thank you. Okay, right. So I'm holding the mic and you're asking a question. I come from Polish Farming Associations. I represent this large food producers in Poland. We operate on 2 million hectares and we are 45,000 people. But unfortunately, we haven't been engaged in meetings with the Prime Minister. Please include us. So, having listened to the debate, my proposal is as follows, because actually I do not have a question. We have the flower of the Polish farming sector. In Europe, well, globally, in such situations, it is very important to have mediators in group disputes. Well, that is necessary to have mediation because we haven't reached an agreement, because we can see tractors out there in the road. So my suggestion is to appoint, well, to choose a mediator in the negotiations between our group and the Prime Minister and the government. We need to choose a person who knows how to represent it. And I suggest Artur Balazs, where I haven't agreed that with anyone here. This is my suggestion. Thank you.
Ja nie wiedziałem o tym, ale no, mogę indeed, powiedzieć tak, że ja nie zastąpię tej reprezentacji,
but let me put it this way. I'm not going to replace this representation,
ja myślę,
which is sitting here. These people are authentic, and I think it would be difficult to gather to group the representation better than this one. I think they will do great.
Dzień dobry, Adrian Pacyna, jestem rolnikiem tutaj z
Adrian Pacyna, I'm a farmer from this region. I have three simple questions. First, the profitability, well, return on farming, when unfortunately our kids do not get student dorms, they do not get any scholarships, etc., because our profitability, our income is calculated on the basis of last year's income.
Dokładnie.
And then my question to Mr. Balázs is, the minister, could we introduce different farming structure in Ukraine? The large Ukrainian food producers should be fragmented into smaller farms and
smaller farms.
And my third question is about the budget of the CAP. In what the amounts haven't changed for years. In the euro, these amounts have remained unchanged. So we had some extra money production during the COVID. So are we going to collect three questions? Sir, would you like to refer to some questions? Zbigniew Serafin. I am a farmer and I'm a milk cattle breeder from this region, and I'm the head of the gathering that we're going to hold tomorrow in Kolbuszów area. Sir, so the government has been in office for 3 months now, and could you tell us about the measures that you introduced on the borders? The minister is not. So, what mechanisms has your government introduced on borders to prevent Ukrainian cereal from entering Poland? My question is about the mechanisms in the EU that the European Commission is moving away from certain concepts, but these concepts must be voted by the parliament. So what happens if the Green Deal stays as it is? Is the mechanism in political terms the same as it is in Poland, or there are commissions that work on certain aspects, and then a bill must be adopted by the parliament. Sir, Minister, could you please reply to these questions?
Well, indeed,
I believe that we want to negotiate from the start. You might have this impression that these negotiations have been going for too long. We would like them to stop or end with stages, and we would like to see some changes taking place. So I would like today to be one stage of this process, or end of a stage in this process. And in a while we'll have a report on what has been agreed here and how we assess it, because that will be used for evaluating our progress. Both parties need it.
Jestem i za udziałem, i bardzo się cieszy i pana przewodniczącego Balázsa, i tego zespołu.
So I'm all for including Mr. Balázs and this team to the negotiation team. And I'll be very happy to meet all farmers who have an intention of negotiating with me. So this is what the Ministry of Agriculture is for, and this is its role.
Z waloryzacją budżetu. No, oczywiście,
as for the budget indexation, when we look at the budget from the historical point of view, well, the farming budget used to take up to 75% of the total EU budget. Well, I think the share of farming represents about 33-34% of the EU budget. I think that Jerzy Plewak, who used to act as the negotiator, well, he might correct me if I'm wrong. But this common agricultural policy has been clearly evolving towards an environmental policy. This is why we have this Green Deal, etc. These elements come at the cost to farming and a burden on the agriculture. And they add to all the burdens imposed on the farming in general. As for Ukraine, well, the structure of the agriculture in Ukraine is what it is. There are large of holdings and the owners of these holdings are elsewhere. We are well familiar with that. So often the measures that result from opening of the European market, they do not reach these small, poor Ukrainian farmers. So speaking about budget indexation, let me say that we need to introduce the specific manner of counting. So we need to have costs on the one side and financing on the other side, juxtapose. And then you're saying that the support for animal production is insufficient, so apparently farmers are moving away from animal production and they take to crops growing. And that is a major issue. Now, about this Green Deal. Well, this is a certain approach to introducing environmental aspects. And there might be some members of the society who subscribe to that and support it. But then when they analyze it, analyze the whole concept, then I think they reconsider and then they're allied with farmers. Sir, two more issues that you haven't answered. One is about the income calculation when it comes to a certain social benefits that members of farmers' families enjoy. And then another question was about compensation for drought. As for droughts, well, and applications, we'll revise it. We know what projects are in the pipeline, and we'll see what can be reconciled or perhaps repaired, but we have that within our focus.
Pytania, to także by na te pytania, które się udzielimy odpowiedzi, to
as for questions, we'll be answering your questions.
Jedno pytanie, ja wiem, że wiele pytań, ale okay, one question.
Just choose one key question, and please be brief.
Bo wszyscy znają, jak to skutki, a nie znają przyczyny.
Everyone talks about consequences, but they are not aware of causes.
Z korupcji. Well,
all what we have in farming is caused by corruption. If someone cannot be a good politician, that person should go, should leave. We're not going to punish anyone, but respect us. Respect us all. Go.
I'm a farmer from Korbuszowa, Anna Serafin. A question. Eco schemes. Why won't the ministry trust the farmers? Why don't you trust our declarations? Why extra statements that we have to file? So the question is, why doesn't the ministry trust the farmers?
Two issues. One,
the difficult situation that we are in, it needs to be remedied. I share my colleagues' perspective. We also have certain expectations. We expect solutions that will continue to work in 5 and 10 years' time. I've got a question up my sleeve here. Veterinary regulations. We've been combating ASF for 10 years' time. As a result, you saw the liquidation of pig production. Soon it will spread this problem. We need a sector-based discussion. Thank you for your question. We need sector-based development programs. We are closing the list because we need to have time to actually put the questions to the minister. Mr. Czapski, the farmers are asking whether they should sow or not, they should plant or not. What can we do to get rid of the old grain, even last year's grain, so that we change the market? What can be done to change the price, to make it move, to nudge it? One question, introduce yourself. I've been surprised, Minister. You've been talking about subsidies for ecosystems. But who's going to get the money? Are the smaller-scale farmers going to get that? Maybe we should get subsidies so that we can buy cow fodder cheaper. So it's a suggestion rather than a question. Artur Konarski, I represent the Świętokrzyskie region. I represent the striking farmers. Minister, we've talked about these things a number of times, and we are rehashing the same subjects. I expected more people from the ministry that would offer ready solutions. And a question. Gentlemen, you're mostly farmers, you represent trade unions for the most part. The question, please ask the question. What are we fighting for? Do we represent our particular interests or do we represent all the farmers' interests? There are oligarchs, there are politicians and MEPs. They have sold our farming sector.
And
I grow food, meat animals. You said that our agriculture are the weak link, but I believe it's the British government and Brussels are the weak links. When do we get back to our normality? When do you start caring about our interests? Let us give the minister an opportunity to respond to the questions so far. There have been quite a few. The weak link, where is it? The management system is also a weak link. There are many areas where the state is not as effective as it should be. So, controls and checks in border crossings. I believe that the people there were not used to proper checks because the goods tended to flow freely.
You
remember those photos, Minister Kozieczak? He went in
a
car because he was not sure that the information he was getting from the services was actually totally
true. W Dargowicach, bo to mój okręg wyborczy, byłem parokrotnie, rozmawiałem. Ja wiem, że jest określona specyfika i zróżnicowanie w polskim rolnictwie. To
now I know that the Polish sector is getting more diverse.
Także pewne elementy wsparcia, czy elementy instrumentów rynkowych trzeba dopasowywać.
Market support tools need to be adapted to a given farming sector. The prices of grain, I've already said it, they don't really depend on what is happening here in Poland. It's various exchanges that shape those prices. And we are working on a program to support grain producers. Minister Kołodziejczak is heading such a team. We would like to subsidize sold grains. We are working on other instruments too. The Ministry of Agriculture, the Ministry of Finance, the Minister of Chancellery are working together to draft such solutions. We want those solutions to be put in place. We want the silos to be emptied. And the farmers need to sell grain because they need money so that they stay liquid and so that they can keep producing.
ASF,
African swine fever. There are certain things that are taken at the European level, decisions taken at the European level, you may agree with those or not. Yet we need to adopt a single stance when it comes to combating ASF, to get rid of it. After all, it's a problem that's linked to food security.
Jest wprowadzone już potem zasada, że nie ma potrzeby wysłania żadnych
rule has been introduced saying that no photos are necessary, a statement is sufficient. After all, it's the farmer that realizes that certain steps need to be taken. So it's good that certain things have been simplified. Dominik Zawadzki, I've got an orchard
Szanowni koledzy i koleżanki, Grujec. O bardzo ważnych sprawach, czyli o rozwiązaniu problemu, który w tej chwili
problem,
mamy. Natomiast nie mówimy nic,
that we have needs to be solved. Nobody has said anything about what's going to happen down the line. Where are we going to sell our produce? The world now is controlled by holdings. We are talking about the Ukrainian problem. What about our problem? The Solidarity Organization has been in talks with various ministers. We have suggested that a holding is set up. So it's a question and a suggestion. Yes, we can talk about production today. We can talk about the number of pigs that we have. We can talk about soft fruit and apples, but we don't have a market where we could sell it. So maybe we should organize a food and farming holding. An attempt has been made in the past, but this was the wrong path. Minister, I hope you can meet us to listen to our suggestion. We agreed on a single question, so be brief.
Marzec i praktycznie
today,
nie zostało
it's March,
10% wniosków rozpatrzonych, a
and every 10th application was reviewed. I'm talking about fruit growers here. We need to plant trees, and this situation needs to be solved. I will hold the mic. You ask the question. But if you're holding the mic, you've got the power.
Agnieszka Weger, przedstawiciel ogólnopolskiego protestu rolników.
I represent the national farmers' protest. A question to the gentleman that you represent, the farmers. How big a group do you represent? That's my question to you, gentlemen. And another question. Yesterday, or rather, it was suggested that an agreement is struck. Do you intend to strike an agreement? Do you claim to represent all the farmers that are going to protest tomorrow? So you are putting this question to the gentlemen sitting at the table, to the panelists. And We will also make it possible for you to ask this question. You can ask the question and then we shall hear answers. Thank you. My name is Grzegorz Majewski. I'm a farmer from Warmian, Mazury. I represent the National Farmers Protests Movement.
W tamtym miejscu siedzi bardzo wielu takich przedstawicieli.
There are many such representatives on the right hand side.
Protesty.
We are organizing protests pytanie? Together. They are my colleagues. And the question, yes.
Żeby nie było takiego problemu, że każdy z nas będzie tutaj podchodził i zadawał po jednym pytaniu, proszę mi pozwolić zadać pytania od całej grupy.
A question for the whole group.
Pytanie,
number one.
Pana organizatora.
To the organizer.
Dlaczego przy tym stole?
Let's look at this table. Why is Mr. Pawlik here? He is the right hand of the minister. You represent Agrounia.
Bardzo dziękuję. Wiadomo o Agrounii. Jest pytanie.
Yes, Agrounia. That's a well-known thing. Ever since you got there, you haven't organized a single strike action. You are there and you admitted officially that you are being financed by Mr. Tusk. And now we shall hear answers to the questions that have been put to the gentleman at the table. First, I respond to the lady's question. Who do I represent? I represent the farmers from the Podkarpacie region and the farmers that are protesting at border crossings. This is the group that I represent, the Eastern group. We have suffered the most because of this influx of grain and other produce. We are not going to sign anything without an agreement with farmers. We have not been selected by anybody. We represent you present in this room. We will keep the channels open. We will be consulting you. But this agreement will include you. If you find something harmful, we're not going to sign it. You know whom I represent. Western Pomerania region is represented here. We've been protesting since September 2022. We need to look for agreements rather than bones of contention. I crisscrossed Stettin 7 times when protests were taking. My name is Władysław Serafin. I represent an organization in Świeck. Hundreds of farmers have given me this mandate. I also represent other protesting groups. Pilskie, Podkarpacie, many regions, many groups have given me the mandate. We all have mandates as we sit here. Let me respond to the lady, ma'am. I'll be happy for you to join us here at the table and I'll go to the audience. You decide. Let's just swap places.
Jeszcze jedno pytanie. Bardzo proszę.
One more question. On a serious note.
Także bardzo proszę, żeby pan skomasował te pytania.
Zaszczyt, ale też czujemy wagę tego.
It's an honor. I to nie jest tak, we feel that it's a proper responsibility on our shoulders.
Tutaj jesteśmy tylko dla pustoty, ale też dlatego, żeby ten problem rozwiązać, bo widzimy.
We are not here to stroke our egos. No. We want to solve the problem. We know what the situation is like. Mr. Minister, please give us the details, the substance. We are here to strike a deal. But you can read the room. People feel that there is too little substance, things you can rely on. I've been asking about ports at 4 meetings so far and about this rail bus. And I have not been listened to.
Let me not just answer that regarding that movement that I represent. Ladies and gentlemen, that union was founded in 1981. That union was fighting for Polish farming, and people were killed because of that. And now we're here to fight for the Polish land, for the Polish soil, and we represent the biggest number of farmers and people who are related to farmers and farming land. To reply about your questions about me, check social media channels since 2018 when Agrounia was on strike on matters important to farmers. In 2022, we had this excellent sale of onion to Ukraine, and I had three trucks per day coming to me to take my onion, and these trucks were transporting cereals. And we went on strike, and I was calling around, asking farmers from every region of Poland, and I was asking, please go on strike with us. And everybody was answering, well, Pawlik, what do you want? We're good, we're fine, please stop that. See, this is what it's like. That we've been active for a number of years. We noticed that problem long time ago, much earlier than you have, and we've been protesting around it. Everyone who is sitting here becomes a party to the others. You need to understand that, madam. So you are on this side here. You are at the table. This is how it works. Let's avoid bargaining. Who was there first? During the time of solidarity, I was in prison for a year, and I could go around and ask, where were you back then? Mr. Pawlik is here because Mr. Kołodziejczak, he is the minister. He's already on the other side, and Mr. Pawlik represents that group of activists that went up and started fighting on barricades much earlier than you have. Do not accuse anyone of not representing the right group of people. I warn you, smart asses, do not do that. Do not try and divide the whole group. It will only turn into misfortune for farmers. We have so many protests happening today, and these protesters will come here and will tell you exactly the same thing that you're saying to everyone here in this theater. I warn you, we do not have a perfect representation. For me, for now, this representation here together with you, madam, is a great representation. Stay together. Do not let anyone divide you. Mr. Pawlik, every time we see you, you walk hand in hand with the Prime Minister. This is your opinion. You have a question. Please ask your question. Okay, so my question is as follows. Why neither you nor Minister Kołodziejczak work with us, cooperate with us as you should? Why you are not with us, although you keep on repeating that you are farmers? And the same question goes to the minister. For 3 months, you've been saying that you support us, that you're with us, that you're support us strongly, and you haven't done a thing. And another question, sir, minister, you are misleading the public opinion because animal breeding is no longer profitable, and farmers start abandoning that type of production. We have all these animal welfare regulations, etc. Please simplify it. Why you cannot simplify it? Why the chairperson of the Animal Welfare Commission is Madam Tracz, who is an activist, and he's
robi ustawę o likwidacji zwierząt futerkowych, której zapisuje, że animal breeding dla likwidacji
and for her this legislation about keeping fur animals is a step towards liquidating the whole system.
Dzień dobry, panie ministrze, do pana takie trzy szybkie pytania. Well,
sir, I have three quick questions to you.
Generalnie wszystko się będzie kręcić wokół wypłaty rekompensat.
Speaking, we'll be talking about compensation. So how advanced your negotiations or talks with the Minister of Finance are? My second question is about the methodology used for calculating the amount of compensations, if a compensation, if any. Thank you, Dariusz Woźniak.
Hi. Gminie Radziąż,
I'm a farmer,
duże gospodarstwo rolne.
And I have a large farm, and I must go on strike, and I joined the demonstrations. Very soon, we won't have the time, we're determined, because we have to farm our land. So is the government really on it? Is the government really engaged, and has this intention to help us, or is that about just stalling the negotiations. And my question again is about demonstrations. Are you really planning to beat up the protesting farmers again?
Ja może tak w pierwszej kolejności odpowiem na to pytanie kolejny raz panu.
So again.
Let me
answer this question. You're asking me why I was attending these meetings. I did want to. You know why? Because in 2018, Prime Minister Morawiecki was opening the ring road in my area. We were asking him to meet farmers, and we asked him so many times, and we wanted to meet him when he was opening, during that, when we was he had that ceremony of opening the ring road. So this is what they did. And during the latest elections campaign, I was working in the election committee for the current deputy minister. And we met Mr. Tusk, Prime Minister Tusk, during the election campaign. And I asked him the following question. I asked him, sir, what is your opinion? What is your view on the future of the Polish farming, forage agriculture? And he said, I know what we lost and I'll do what I can. And this is why I really wanted you to have be at the meeting. You were at the meeting. You sat at the table. And you know what pained me? You were saying one thing at the table and then it pained me that one when you left the room and you spoke to the mass media, to the cameras, you spoke something entirely different. When it comes to financing projects filed with the agency, please approach me later on. We'll talk to the people from the agency or they will reply to you in writing because we need to clarify these issues. So when it comes to the animal production, animal breeding, what I spoke about that, I think, then when it comes to discussions, the debating with the Ministry of Finance, I left it at the very end, and we are now discussing these issues, and we're at the level of reaching an agreement, and I think that by the end of March we can reach an agreement here to have that clear, this unambiguous decision of the Minister of Finance, which is also acceptable to the Prime Minister. So when we talk cereals, we talk to the cereals people. when we talk about other industries here, we talk to a competent representation. Ladies and gentlemen, I think that the government takes a very serious approach to your difficulties, to your issues. We organize like a four-hour rounds, so you can, those who take part in these debates, these negotiations, they can confirm that the government truly listens, and we have the intention to solve these issues. Thank you. One more question.
Now, in the contingent, when you count it, why do you consider the wartime years? Corn, 5.9 thousand tons came in 1 year. Now, 2022, 1,800,000 and change. It was a huge difference. The wartime years cannot be taken into account when you make this calculation. Andrzej, thank you very much.
Andrzej
Dziadek, a farmer. A few questions, a few issues. I'll begin with the following. The Green Deal is mentioned, but what I see is just the tip of the iceberg. Below you see farming and GMO ban, and yet you've got GMO soya imported, same for corn. Neonicotinoid compounds also are not allowed, and yet we import food where such compounds are used. Nitrogen also limitations. You don't have those limitations abroad. And the question, why is the EU trying to destroy the Polish farming? What is it about? Is it about the market? Is it about the grain? Is it supposed to come in from Ukraine and Russia? Because what you see here in this discussion is a certain icing. But we cannot be competitive when we are facing all those EU regulations at the same time, the Polish regulations. Mr. Minister, question to you. I'm an active, or rather the concept of active farmer. When, if,
...1900
applications for direct subsidies, over 300 farmers that actually produce. Are you going to do something about that or not? Be honest in your answer. Mariusz.
Wawrzyło Mariusz, organizator protestów w Nagłowicach.
One of the protest organizers. Sir, we've met three times. We spoke on the phone on Sunday.
Czy jeszcze nie? Czy jeszcze będziemy musieli czekać?
Minister,
mam nadzieję, że już rozwiązania jakieś znalazłeś.
Do you have a solution or not? Grain subsidies, diesel subsidies, 2 zlotys. And we have written documents. We wrote papers, but you said you couldn't do anything. And in Nagłowice, we've been protesting for over a month. How long do we need to stay there so that you can act? Because I need to return there and tell them whether they need to protest or not. Another question. Dr. Plewa, he met us yesterday and he spoke rubbish. He spoke that our protests are unjustified and there is no grain coming for Ukraine. That's what he said yesterday. Tell him what the Green Deal is and tell him the truth about the grain from Ukraine. Hello, my name is Tadeusz Kuśnierz. I'm a farmer from Błażowa, a commune in Podkarpacie. I am participating in the strikes.
Jaka różnica była między 43 lata temu, że temperatura była minus 15, 43
years ago it was minus 15, now it's plus 15. Basically, the talks are only about softening us. Soon the farmers will have to go to the fields and plant and sow. Three issues. One, you don't change the rules of the game during the game. There was this contract signed last year about silos. New conditions were put in place. I grow.
Którym kawałku, mało tego, muszę siedzibę stada i codziennie, gdybym tak się pewno, muszę przemieszczenie robić. A trzecia sprawa,
you are proszę pana, making that difficult. Thirdly, poultry.
Wie pan, ja mam trzy
there is this threshold. I've got 30 hens, roughly. I need to take stock. I've got two roosters. And one rooster goes to my neighbor and hardly ever returns.
Marzena Waria, panie ministrze, jedno zasadniczą Dobrów. Odpowiedź i pytanie. Proszę
simple
powiedzieć,
question,
kiedy
I need a simple answer.
Chcę
tell us, when is it going to end? I'm a protester, I'm one of the organizers. I need to go to my colleagues and give them an answer.
Kiedy
I need to give an answer to women.
Nasze chłopy będą z nami w domu
when
siedzieć, a nie, na
are
granicy,
the men
na
going to be with us at home rather than protesting at the border crossing?
Poprosimy o odpowiedź na pytania.
Shall we have answers to those questions? Minister?
Pytanie było od pani, kiedy...
The lady asked, when are the protests going to end? Effectively, that was the question. I believe we will come to a conclusion, to an agreement.
So,
I know that you have been protesting for a long time. I've met you a number of times. I've always been well received. You cared about the situation in the farming sector. I appreciate that. I want to say it out loud. Now, the issue at hand. I know that there are certain issues related to the regulations. The regulations are as they are. We have simplified many things already. In our agency, we keep discussing that, looking for things that can be simplified so as to cut as much red tape as possible for you. And I've been talking to the agency managers about just that. Now the detailed questions. I'll try to draft answers and send them to you. I believe we will come to a conclusion because this is the only way to solve problems. You need to come to an agreement. Let me declare that I will do everything to convince the Ministry of Finance, the Prime Minister and my colleagues. The Minister of Agriculture cannot be the sole decision maker.
Mr.
Banaś expressed certain expectations. He said that I need to be brave, and I am brave. The farmers' problems will be solved the way they need to be solved. The problem is not just a Polish problem, it's a broader issue. There was a meeting of the member states' ministers of agriculture. We talked about it there too. I've received phone calls. People were thanking Mr. Tusk, the Prime Minister, because the Green Deal position was quite decisive. And some people said they never expected the Commission, the European Commission, to make such large concessions. It's quite an achievement on the part of the Polish farmers. We are on the right track, I believe. Paweł Starczewski, NSZZ Solidarność. Mr. Balaś. Piotr Bartoszcze's death.
Scen, co Tomek był zresztą, że obchodzili.
Pytanie do pana Balasza.
Was marked, and you were not there.
Bo ja byłem, gdzie była.
So remember about such events. Yes, we remember that. It's history, and we remember history. There is this special fund. Farms have been developing, but the prices are dumping prices, and farms may be failing. These people will stay on the roads. First questions. You've already asked questions, so we are not going to have a discussion in this formula. I've asked about the so-called active farmer. Let me just remind you. You shall have a special act, a relevant act, that will also cover the issue of lease and the so-called active farmers.
Tego rolnika, który wydzierżawia swoją ziemię i dla tego rolnika, który będzie dzierżawił.
So the lessee and the lesser can actually benefit.
Ten rolnik, który na tej ziemi pracuje i dzierżawa musi być przeprowadzona w sposób.
So the lease needs to be carried out responsibly. At the same time, the property right needs to be respected.
I się robi pod nią inwestycje, to wypowiedzenie musi być z określonym wyprzedzeniem.
You need to stick to your word, and you must not have a situation when a deal is terminated overnight, because after all, investments are made and the lease can be terminated overnight. You need a transition period. And the rules need to be clear.
Chciałem odpowiedzieć na to pytanie dotyczące obecności na rocznicę śmierci.
So a proper notice period is necessary. Piotr Bartoszcze, his death anniversary was marked, and I signed the deal.
Zwłaszcza od Krzysztofa.
The agreement. I've received invitations whenever I do. I go there.
Co do której obchodów nikt mi nie dał znać, jak.
But I'm not going to attend an event that I had never been notified of. I remember Piotr. It was a difficult strike. I remember it. As a result, the Farmers Solidarity Union was formally registered. So it's difficult to attend an event, to summarize, that you were never notified of.
Proszę bardzo, dalsze pytanie.
Let us move on with the questions.
Szanowni Państwo, przede wszystkim chcę serdecznie podziękować rolnikom, którzy.
I would like to say thank you to the farmers that decided to defend the Polish farming sector. When we defend the agricultural sector, we are defending Poland, because a healthy economy has agriculture as a foundation. Let me remind you the following. We used to defend the Polish agricultural sector too, the dairy sector. They actually sent out the military. And we were supported, we fought, and that gave good results because this industry continues to be in the Polish hands.
Nie chcę tu przypominać, ale nasze twarde boje, twarde.
And we fought And we fought hard. As a result, we continue to hold 40% of the sugar sector. If it hadn't been for that, the Germans would have bought out all of the Polish sugar market. I was courageous enough to oppose those capital and political groups. Those same capital and political groups have been destroying the Polish and European farming for a reason. Because if they have lower quality cheap food, you can spend money on rubbish. And that's the logic that dominates today. We need to remember about time limits. Please ask a question. I don't have any questions. I'll give you a short definition, gentlemen. And a question too.
Gdzie patrzył? Na stopy czy końca bruzy? No, minister.
Ja też to pamiętam, także bardzo dziękuję.
Yes, I remember that anecdote too. You've already asked me about that.
Patrzył końca bruzdy i wtedy równo orał. A
so basically,
patrzy pod stopy, słuchajcie.
The EU is not looking ahead.
Mój pomysł na rolnictwo jest następujący.
They need to look ahead at the objectives on the horizon. So CAP, the CAP should be a framework. The thing is, member states should fill in that framework with the national specific regulations. We know well locally what to do. Nobody in Brussels are going to tell us what to do in detail. Because you know, when you have those detailed regulations that do not take into account the local, national, regional conditions.
Yes,
I'll give you some extra time for that. Gentlemen.
Jan Bocian, obserwując dzisiejszą debatę, ale również całą sytuację.
Well, following this debate, I have this question to the minister. Are there two teams working in parallel in order to solve two different topics? One is about the current situation, which is markedly different to what we've been discussing here. It's about the strategy. So first, we should not confuse a debate about the surplus of farming production in Europe and globally with the Green Deal. That was consulted in reality 10 years ago. Very often, our representations haven't been invited to these consultations. So, will the Polish agricultural policy include a provision that 3-5% will be allocated to implementation of innovative projects in food processing sector? Because nowadays we cannot compete on the market with products produced with outdated technology. So we won't keep up in 5-10 years. Most funds have been directed and channeled towards direct payments. Less funds is allocated to working loans, working facilities.
Thank
you. Tomorrow we're going to discuss innovation during our panels. Thank you. I have four more questions, but I will just ask one of these. I will not be asking about the transits, about the unhealthy food flooding our markets, supermarkets. The question that I want to ask is as follows. What agreement do you want to sign with us today? So far, you haven't proposed or suggested any solution. Are you ashamed of these solutions? that you don't want to offer them here to us. We represent the entire country. Please present these solutions to us, and we can evaluate them and we'll appraise them very quickly. My fear is that our view on these solutions will be very different. This is my concern. Well, let me share my concern with you. The colleague that has spoken as the last one, and madam that has joined us at this table, participated in several rounds of negotiations with the Prime Minister and with the minister here. And these negotiations, these talks, didn't close with any closing points. No matter has been solved, and they liked it. And however, today, when there is a chance that some matters that have been touched here, and specifically that is Ukraine and the border, that is worth reaching an agreement, I see that these persons are concerned, are really concerned by the fact that an agreement could be reached. Mind you, farmers need that agreement. Farmers need that agreement when it comes to agricultural policy when dealing with Ukraine. If we don't solve it, no intervention, no amount of budgetary funds can solve it. We will have no solution because we won't be intervening on our market, but on the Ukrainian market. No one will keep secret. Will keep this agreement secret. If we sign this agreement, we will present it to you. So it is no secret at all. Madam, you're here with us at this table. So then, of course, once we have these negotiations with the minister, of course you will join us in the negotiations because you don't care about reaching an agreement. There are some people who are here just to prevent reaching an agreement. You do not. You are not here in the interest of farmers. That's the truth. I sat at many negotiation tables, and I've settled many problems. I was also engaged in negotiations with the EU. I wasn't engaged in that. I prepared the negotiation position that assumed full direct payment from the day of joining the EU. And then the commissioners, they came up with the idea that they didn't want to open these negotiations in the area of farming because they wanted to avoid these difficult issues of negotiations. And that's the truth. That's the truth about the negotiations. Ladies and gentlemen, farmers are in a dramatically difficult situation. In particular, those who are on strike do not use their interest for your own sake. Well, actually, I was unfairly described here. Why didn't you allow us to sit at the table? Every time with our meetings with the Prime Minister, we need to shout out to be included in these negotiations. As you were saying, as you said yourself, you were present at these meetings, and these meetings were futile. And I believe that today we have a chance to start this process of negotiations, to agree on what is important for farmers. So we have this unfair Ukrainian competition. We want to block it. Do not interrupt it.
Dzień dobry, Barna Stanisław, Zachodniopomorskie.
I come from Western Pomeranian region. I represent farmers from the Western Pomeranian, from many regions in Poland.
Dzisiaj praktycznie nie ma przy tym okazałem stole.
They are not sitting here at your table. Mr. Balazs, sir, do not say that we're good for nothing, that we have no negotiation skills.
Kołodziejczaka i przez pana Filipka.
Minister Kołodziejczak, Mr. Filipek, they invited not the people that we wanted to be to represent us. It seems that they've gathered people who are not the right representatives of our group. So my question is, are we signing an agreement? Gentlemen, are you going to sign an agreement? If you are, how about the strikes today and tomorrow? People in Poland are aggrieved, and we've been discussing here for 2 hours right now, and you haven't answered our question. We had 8 meetings. Do you have the answer for Poland? What is going to happen to the farming, what to the agriculture in Poland? Are we going to develop? Excuse me, sir, but there I come from the Western Pomeranian region, and I've been always engaged in negotiations. I was calling Wiesiu and Romek and Artur and Tomek and other colleagues here, and I had 2 last meetings with them. Please forgive us a question, sir.
Nie potrafimy negocjować.
Mr. Balasz said that we cannot negotiate.
Proszę mi dać powiedzieć. Proszę mi dać powiedzieć, skończę i już więcej się nie będę.
You would have a question.
Zaczęliśmy w tamtym roku protestować. Wywalczyliśmy w Szczecinie te wszystkie pomocy, które były. Potrafiliśmy rozmawiać. I tylko z panem Filipkiem protestowaliśmy i z panem Wiesławem. I to trzeba docenić. A nie dzisiaj jest reprezentacja rolników i wszystkich protestów.
Well, today we have a representation of farmers and who do you, where do you come from? Who appointed you? Who delegated you? Just let me refer to that.
Był u mnie dzisiaj przed tymi rozmowami.
Oczywiście bardzo chciał. We met before these talks. He wanted to join these negotiations and he wanted to sit at this table. And my answer was as follows. I have a representation here, but there is, but I don't see a problem with engaging you in the negotiations. But he said that if he doesn't sit, if he wouldn't sit at this table, then he would start an argument. That's the way it was. No.
It was not the right way to discuss after that debate. West Pomerania, minister.
Tematem następującym. Ja jestem rolnikiem, oczywiście.
I'm a farmer, too. I deal with commodities. I have a large farm.
I również zajmujemy się.
Basically, we are entrepreneurial too.
Serdecznie zapraszam na moje gospodarstwo.
You can visit my farm to see for yourselves.
Skupami zbóż.
We also buy grain.
Na dzień dzisiejszy jestem w posiadaniu ponad 60 tysięcy ton zboża.
60,000 tons of grain is in my ownership. We have bought it from a number of various communes and regions.
Proszę mi powiedzieć, co
so takie question.
Podmioty jak mój mają dzisiaj, jaką państwo.
What are entities such as mine supposed to do? Can you offer us anything? I'll be brief. We cannot deal with that on our own. I'm speaking for myself and on behalf of a number of entrepreneurs. The entrepreneurs that have found ourselves in this situation, we do not import from the East. One more gentleman, and we will close the list. I'm a farmer from Podkarpacie region. I've been farming for half a century.
Ja taki, najpierw konkluzja.
First a conclusion, minister. You knew ahead of time who you're going to govern with. You knew what needed to be fixed. If you didn't know that, then your friends did. It's their responsibility. You have taken it upon yourself to serve, because a minister is supposed to serve. You knew what you were doing, where you were headed. I've been listening to what you've been saying, and you have not given us anything specific. Is it difficult to stop Ukrainian grains importation for half a year? No, it's not impossible. It's doable. The German market will survive because they have the processing capacity. We will defend ourselves because we have good quality grain. You should have closed the border. And only then should you start the discussion. I know that you are smart, but what of it? Please ask a question. I'm going to say but once. Farmers are determined. Do you think that it is not detrimental to our health? It is. It's a joke what you're saying. You have taken it upon yourself to serve as a minister. If you cannot deliver, just resign and let other younger people to serve.
Panie ministrze,
Mr. Minister, my name is Gudrun Brendrejek. I represent one of the agricultural chambers. You are threatening us with war. You're asking us to help Ukraine. The Polish nations have stepped up. They did that. But now you are supporting environmental terrorists, environmentalists, and people that produce in Ukraine. Who is it that you're helping? We've had a number of meetings. The thing is, we have not heard any solutions. Minister, when are we going to get solutions? How can we sign an agreement under these conditions? In a moment, you said you need to convince the Ministry of Finance and the Prime Minister to give funding. We cannot sign anything if you have not secured funding. You have decided to take over the courts and the TV. You did that in days, and yet you are unwilling to help the farmers. Please ask a question. One more question, and there will be a supplemental. Ministers, MPs, presidents, colleagues, friends, we've been at it for 2 hours, been observing what's going on. We don't like some people because they don't have the right mandate. People are arguing about the number of protests that they have organized. Dear colleagues, dear friends, farmers, we represent the Polish countryside. How many farmers do we have here? 13 million applications for area payments, but this is how many applications we have. But we, as we sit here, there are a few hundreds of us, and here we are supposed to discuss the Polish farming sector. Yes, we can shout out how much we've done. A representative of Czechia is here. I live close to Czechia. I meet our Czech colleagues. I work with them. So, an appeal. Let's finish this discussion. Everything has been said. We need to hammer out one, two, or three postulates that the government will have to meet willy-nilly. And this is my appeal here to all of you. Let me add something. It's not just the farmers that have a problem. The ministry has a problem too. It is something that was raised as early as 2014. And Law and Justice, this party, they had been in power for 8 years and they did nothing. I asked this grain to be burned. It should have been burned as fuel. And then we would have heat. We would have it better. Orban, Hungary, they could do it. And we couldn't. Maybe for once we will be smart ahead of time rather than after the fact. Minister, how long do we need to wait? Easter is coming. How long do we need to keep our protests? What do I say to my colleagues and friends? Do they stay there or do they go? I demand an answer. Is there anyone at the table that would like to take the floor? Sir, Minister, the protests have been carried out by young people, and young people are impatient. Young people are right. We cannot go on like that. You cannot carry on like that. I'm speaking what people here believe. Every day in the morning, we take a decision. I was warning you 3 months ago. Nothing has happened. You can just make a phone call. Call the Prime Minister. You can call the Prime Minister or the Minister of Finance, and we can finish it today. We have goodwill. We want to come out of this meeting with something, not empty-handed. It is not only about farmers. There are companies that are linked to the sector, even large companies, they are still waiting. We want people to have a sense of security, at least now for this vegetative season. We're not sure whether to sow or not. We know nothing. We don't have information. These are not just empty words where people talk about food security. And the farming defense is shrinking. The security defense has been shrinking, and you see what's come out of it. What we need is a conclave. The participants need to be kept without food or water until they've taken a decision. You represent the Council of Ministers. Let us stop this dance. Do not believe that farmers are going to stop the protests. They are young people in their 20s and 40s. They are not going to stop their protests. I've got a son, he's a farmer, and I'm not sure that I made the right choice when I encouraged him to be a farmer. Minister, you have to choose. Artur Kącik, Minister, as we've heard, we need talks today. We need specifics today. If you don't do it, call the Prime Minister and say that Poland will come to a halt, including transportation. And it will come to a halt for good. The farmers have their backs against the wall. We've heard it today. You have the power, you can use it at any point in time. Here we are. We've come here to discuss the details with you. We don't want to extend it. You have had a week. You've had a conversation with the Prime Minister. You've had a week to consider this and give us specifics. All thanks to Minister Balázs. Today is a historical moment. We will stay here till 4 a.m. or 5 a.m., but we're not going to leave. What are we going to say to our colleagues? A lady said, our husbands and sons are missing. What do we do with all the loans, with the mortgages? We've got silos filled with grain. We're not going to keep investing because it's pointless, Minister. We have invested millions since 2004. All of us as we sit here. And you have been encouraging us to do that. What do we do with this machinery? My colleague needs to pay loan installment, and he has no money. He may have to sell it, but we're not sure if he's going to be able to sell it because nobody might want to buy it. We are not going to wait any further. Andrzej Sobociński, Minister. I have been listening to all the postulates also presented by the members of the audience, and they were specific. The only specific you mentioned was linked to the Green Deal. And even that is just a proposal. There is no draft so far. Ever since January the 24th, we've had talks. We've been listening to you. There was a meeting with the Prime Minister. You have listened in, or rather you listened in, you never took the floor, and then the Prime Minister said the Ministry is not helping. The Ministry is not giving solutions. We need solutions. If there are no solutions, heads will roll. We don't want that. We care about a solution. Minister. You cannot use that kind of language. We are trying, we are attempting, we are considering. No time for that. You need to talk to us. Have you come empty-handed, just like you have been coming empty-handed so far? I'm sure you have consulted the Prime Minister, the Ministry of Finance. We've heard that there are two proposals. One is a systemic solution, taking the surplus of grain from the market and compensation for the farmers due to what they lost because of this economic warfare. Are you ready to sit at a table and negotiate properly? Or are we going to just go home? Remember what Artur said. We have an opportunity, a proper opportunity to hammer something out. Yes, it's something that needs to be tackled. A bullet needs to be bitten. There won't be a compromise. Because if you have a half-baked compromise, you'll just continue to pay. Are you going to keep paying 1 year down the line?
Pan przewodniczący Obszański, bardzo proszę.
Mr. Obszański.
Proszę państwa, jeszcze się chcę powtarzać.
I don't want to repeat myself.
Rzeczami, które tutaj były powiedziane, no bo jest generalnie bałagan. I to w naszym kraju, w
there is a lot of mess in our country, in our ministry. Let me remind you what I've said. Most questions addressed at the minister was about incompetent people, incompetent employees. Mr. Minister, we should draft a list of people that do not work for the Polish farming. People need to sit down and start working.
Ci ludzie są dalej, nic nie jest z tym robione.
Those people are still
niech będą fachowcy, niech będą ludzie,
holding their posts. We need experts, proper experts. They can do the job. We don't need people who do nothing. We don't need people like that. That's the essence. The problems can be solved here in Poland.
Odniosę się troszkę do
so that's my request.
No, bo niestety izby rolnicze są
farmers chambers, another issue.
2% idzie z nas. Też niech się wezmą trochę do roboty i też niech zaczną działać, bo
it's 2% of our taxes. They should roll up their sleeves and start working. I have seen no action there. We need to be clear about that.
Tak to wygląda i tutaj
that's how things are.
Musowo izby, niech się izby wezmą
so the farming chambers, they need to get down to work and start working.
Dziękuję. Panie ministrze, proszę o
minister.
Takie z pana strony. Aha, momencik, ja oddam tutaj izbą głos.
I'll give the floor to the farming chambers. Be brief, please.
Tomek, jeszcze nie tak dawno napisałeś mi list, że nie mam się prawa odzywać w sprawie strajków i różnych rzeczy.
You have said that I have no right to speak about strikes. I mean actual job that needs to be done. Okay.
Dzisiaj co potrzeba zrobić na wsi?
What do we need to do? Yes, we need compensation and a consolidation loan over 20 years, 1-2% rate, so that people can begin from scratch. This help is needed. People cannot pay off their loans, their mortgages, they cannot afford fertilizer payments.
Proszę bardzo, panie
ministrze. Chciałbym, ja rozumiem charakter wystąpień.
I understand.
Ja rozumiem charakter wystąpień. Rozumiem
nature of your interventions. I understand that you're upset. I understand that you hold a grudge. But please remember, I have been a minister for 3 months. Do not blame me for the previous 8 years. I can take responsibility because I am a minister. I do not need to be a minister. I've always been coming to this summit here at Jasionka. I believe this is the place where different views clash, where the Polish interests and agricultural interests are discussed seriously. I will work for the benefit of the farmers. This is how I worked at the European Commission.
So
I have held important posts. I have been democratically elected, and people were happy when I was the first person to talk about the Green Deal. I was the first one to discuss the issue of Ukraine. It is an important thing, but at the same time, you need to consider other conditions. Russia has a say, and there are certain global prices. All of that impacted the low profitability of the agriculture. And this is the starting point here of this discussion. You are asking me what I did in the past, I could ask you what you did in the past. Whenever I worked for the budget committee, I would always ask about farming. There is evidence. I would always ask and talk about this difficult situation. I've done that. I will continue to do it, whatever position I have. I know full well that we need to sit at a table with the farmers, we need to discuss things, but please do not attack one another. Let us not doubt or undermine our competencies. You know, even the parliament is democratically elected, and we may not like some of the people who sit there, so do not undermine the mandate of the people that are represented here. I remember once I asked almost 200 people, they were present there, TV cameras were present, anybody could take the floor and speak.
dostępu do kamery czy mikrofonu.
Anyone could take the mic and take the floor and speak for the cameras to see.
Aby po prostu przekonać społeczeństwo do swoich racji.
I want to convince people. When there are protests, I always say, do not blockade people, because as a result, you are only basically turning people into your enemies. You need to convince, you need to make people understand. If you blockade things, if you block things, you only turn people into enemies. At this point, you have a lot of social support, and you need to use it. You need to set it at a table. You need to discuss proper arguments. I'll return to it in a moment. You have this unity. Do not destroy it. Yes, there were different protests, organized differently.
You have
social media today. As I said to Minister Banaś, it used to be easier to talk. In the past, you would speak to Leper, late Leper. You might have liked him or not, but he was the face of the whole movement, or at least a large part of the farmers' movement. For the right reason, it was a bit easier. Gabriel Janowski, I remember him from the university. I remember when he protested, fought for democracy. They sacked him from the university because of that. Yes, he is quite, well, he's who he is, but you know, we are simply different. Maybe there is too much diversity in the farming movement. There is no representation that would consistently present the arguments to the government, to the central authorities. Szmulewicz has raised a number of arguments. I've talked with him. To sum up, Minister Kołodziejczak has not been present because he's at the Council of Ministers. Oh, is he now? And certain solutions are being drafted. We want to pay subsidies to grain per ton, each ton that is sold, depending on the period, you know, 200, 300 zlotys per ton, depending on when. Also, we want to include payments for animals, for sows, for example, so that we can boost animal production. Pig production, we would like to boost that. The farming tax for 2024, the fourth installment will be lowered. 2 zloty subsidy for diesel. We want that. We are also considering transportation subsidies so that grain market shifts, structural things, aktywny rolnik, the active farmer, lease is another thing that we are working on. Vertical integration, I mean the farmers and the processing industry, we want to work on that. It has been neglected for a long time. We want to talk about it in groups, sectoral groups. We want to discuss those specific things in specific sectors and suggest solutions to various different groups of producers. We are very much open.
jestem zwolennikiem, żebyśmy dali odetchnąć rolnikom.
Yes, farmers need some respite. I'm very much in favor of that. We need to prepare solutions, and I believe that they will have been defined at the central level by the end of the month. We can return to them after some time. We are not trying to stay away from the subject. It just needs to be discussed. Now, the talks with Ukraine, they are quite advanced. Ukraine has made promises that they promised that the transit through Poland will be limited to the necessary minimum. The infrastructure will be freed. Now, Agroport, Mr. Gryn talked about that. I called you member of the parliament. You are not, but you know, the future is bright. You can accomplish anything in life.
So I promise that I will listen to you, but I'm a responsible person. I cannot give you too many promises. You witnessed these conversations with the Prime Minister, and he went very far when it comes to this Green Deal decisions. And I was called by my counterparts from other countries, and they were asking me about the reasons why it happened. So, Ukraine, etc. This influx is not as you describe it. We still have embargo in place. Well, we are aware of the fact that this transit traffic has some loopholes, but I'm not responsible for the border security and for border transfer. We have our phytosanitary services on the border, but there is a number of ministries involved. Otherwise, we cannot solve it. And the truth is, as presented in reports, that we attach too much attention to every single detail, and we put too much pressure on Ukraine, but we must come up with solutions which will work in the future too. We must be persistent. We must be quite strict when it comes to certain restrictions when it comes to Ukrainian presence in the EU. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll slowly be moving towards the end of this debate.
Jesteśmy w trudnej sytuacji.
We are in a difficult situation.
Natomiast
there is no perfect solution. But the future is not all roses.
Ja niczego nie muszę udowadniać. Za mnie,
I do not need to prove anything. I have my life history, my experience, and I belong more to the past than to the present.
Tradycja tych strajków pierwszych 80.
This location, Jasionka, goes back in history to 1981, has this tradition of Józef Śliż, and these conferences were held here every year. We haven't planned for this conference in its current shape, but I actually was prompted to change the program, the agenda of this conference, and have this debate in place. In my opinion, it is a great thing that it happened. Do not accuse me of being incompetent, of not having good intentions. Indeed, I understand that we're in a very difficult position because we're in a muddle. We will not get out of this muddle with one simple twist or shake, or we need to be determined. We must act with courage to resist agreeing to certain solutions at the EU level. If we do not approach an agreement today, I make myself very clear. I'll exclude myself from these co-negotiations. And on top of that, I don't think that they will going to reach an agreement. On the contrary, there will be many protests and arguments intensifying. And,
Panie ministrze, Panie ministrze, apeluję z tego miejsca do pana, jak i do wszystkich.
Well, so minister, sir, I am addressing you and other people present here. Do all you can to reach an agreement. If you leave this building tonight without reaching an agreement, we'll be facing chaos and extreme dissatisfaction of farmers. And this dissatisfaction will be turned against the government, the authorities, but also those who represent you, ladies and gentlemen, here, who've been shouting so much here in this hall. So my suggestion is right now to stop the debate, this exchange, for the an hour and a half, and later on meet and talk about possible reconciliation to reach a compromise and work out solutions that can be applied, and let us reach some agreement and let's hear some clear declarations from the government. If we succeed, that's all very well. If we don't, then we'll publish a message, a communique. And so I invite you, ladies and gentlemen, in an hour and a half, I invite you, madam, too. So this is an important news for the media, for our colleagues from the media. In an hour, in 1 hour and a half, we'll have a briefing or some short press briefing. And then we'll see how we're going to proceed. Thank you.